Greetings and welcome to this online worship opportunity coming to you from the neighborhood church in Palos Verdes. We're delighted that you have taken time to be with us as we do turn our hearts and trust toward God in this time of worship. Today we celebrate the fact that Christ is the light of the world, and so we want to begin now by lighting the Christ candle on our communion table. Friends, as people of faith, we do gather in the light of Christ. We celebrate this reality in our lives, how Christ illumines the path for us as we go forward in life. And so as we come into this time of worship, let's come worshiping our God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, as now we hear the prelude.
Thank you. now let us all come together, even though we are apart. And in our worship, let us begin by our opening prayer. As journeyers with Christ, we affirm your presence, O God, giver of love and light, grateful for all that has been in our lives and trusting in your promised future, through the one who is our light, ever Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our scriptural reading for today is from the book of John, chapter 8, verses 12 through 20. Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Then the Pharisees said to him, you are testifying on your own behalf. Your testimony is not valid. Jesus answered, even if I testify on my own behalf, my testimony is valid because I know where I have come from and where I am going. But you do not know where I come from or where I am going. You judge by human standards. I judge no one. Yet even if I do judge, my judgment is valid. For it is not I alone who judge, but I and the Father who sent me. In your law, it is written that testimony of two witnesses is valid. I testify on my own behalf. And the Father who sent me testifies on my behalf. Then they said to him, where is your Father? Jesus answered, you know neither me nor my Father. If you knew me, you would know my Father also. He spoke these words while he was teaching in the treasury of the temple, but no one arrested him, because his hour had not yet come. May the Lord grant us meaning and understanding to this, the reading of the Holy Word.
What a world we live in, with earthquakes, famines, fires, winter tornadoes, snowstorms, frigid temperatures, and here in Southern California, sunshine. And through it all, our text this morning brings us these words from Jesus, I am the light of the world. Last week, we were called one of the most basic and formative identities of God when he encountered Moses in the burning bush. God's personhood was revealed as simply, I am. Now, throughout these Lenten Sundays, we are exploring the connection of that identity with Jesus's I am statements. We began a week ago with embracing his sustaining presence when he said, I am the bread of life. Now, due to all of the snowstorms that covered a good part of our nation for the past week or two, I remembered a story one of the great preachers of the last 50 years told. It was when Dr. Fred Craddock shared about the time he was to give two lectures in mid-October at the University of Winnipeg in Canada. He gave the first one on a Friday night, but by the next morning, there was 2 feet of snow covering the area. His host couldn't get to him, so he suggested that Fred walk down the block to a bus station which had a cafe. Fred made it to the cafe where other stranded strangers were gathered. He asked for a menu, and a man in a greasy apron said, "What do you want a menu for?" "We have soup, that's all." So Fred ordered the soup, and the man brought the soup to Fred. He tasted it. Yuck! It was awful. It was kind of gray looking, and it was so bad he couldn't eat it. But he did put his hands around the bowl and bent over the soup because it was warm. Then the door opened, and in came a woman clutching her little coat, and the greasy apron man said, "What do you want?" And she said, "Just a glass of water." He said, "You have to order, lady. Look, I have customers that pay. If you're not going to order, you've got to leave." And he got real loud about it. She got up to leave and started toward the door. And almost as if rehearsed, everyone in that little cafe stood up and started for the door. And the man in the greasy apron said, all right, she can stay." Everybody sat down, and he brought her a bowl of soup. The place grew quiet. Everybody was eating this soup. And Craddock concluded the story saying, "I started eating the soup, and it was pretty good soup. I have no idea what kind of soup it was. I don't know what was in it. But I do recall when I was eating it, it tasted a little like bread and wine. Just a little like bread and wine." Friends, a bowl of gray-looking soup, tasteless, became transformed into something like bread and wine. And that reminds me of how God, at work through Jesus, quite often took things that seemed small and insignificant and managed to shine a light on them and transform them into matters of great importance. I am the God who is beyond time, transcends time, and comes to us in the only time there is, the present moment of our lives. Now, I can say I am cold, I am hot, I was strong, I was scared, but I seldom say, "I am." In Mark's gospel, Jesus asked the disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" And then in John's gospel, chapter 8, verse 58, he said, "Before Abraham was, I am." As I mentioned in last week's sermon, Jesus says 26 times in John, "I am." Listen to these thoughts by Helen Malicote. "I was regretting the past and fearing the future. Suddenly, my Lord was speaking, 'My name is I am.' He paused. I waited. He continued. When you live in the past with its mistakes and regrets, it's hard. I am not there. My name is not I was. When you live in the future with its problems and fears, it's hard. My name is not I will be. When you live in this moment, it is not hard. I am here. My name is I am. I am the light of the world," says Jesus. a little girl was on stage during a church program. And when it came time for her to deliver her lines about Jesus, she stepped forward and she said, "My mom is the light of the world." Now, parents can be very important lights in our lives, but they are not the same as Jesus. If they are truly helping us in our faith, they will point to Jesus. Here are a few verses from the beginning of John's gospel. "All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What was to come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. And there was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world." You see, we are given in life opportunities to testify, to point, to recognize and help others recognize, just as others have helped us recognize, to see. Think of people in your life who have pointed you to the light. Perhaps it was during difficult times, or when you really needed guidance. But think of people who pointed you to the light of faith. Jesus said, "I am the light." And we affirm that in worship each week when we spend time lighting the candle on our communion table, as we reflect on and affirm that Christ is the light of our lives. And so here again, a portion of today's text. "Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, 'I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. I judge no one. Yet, even if I do judge, my judgment is valid, for it is not I alone who judge, but I and the Father who sent me." Our faith is not exclusive of other faiths. I believe the best in all religions focuses on the same light, spirit, and truth. For us who are part of the neighborhood church, Christ is the light. Think about light in your daily and nightly life. When and where do you need it the most? And in terms of your whole life, when is light most helpful? How many thousands of times have we turned on a light to see? How many days have we relied on the sun to see? In our faith, how many times do we turn on Jesus, turn to Jesus to see? When do we rely on the sun, S-O-N? And as if in response in Isaiah 61, the prophet says, "Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you." And Jesus says in Matthew 5:14, you are the light of the world. We are not the source, but we do have a portion of the light, and we are called to reflect it from the true source and to share it. I love the counsel of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. when he said, "Everyone must decide whether he or she will walk in the light of creative altruism or in the destructive darkness of selfishness." And this thought as well. He said, darkness cannot put out darkness. Only light can do that. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. As we walk into the week ahead, I'd like you to take this I am statement of Jesus with you. I am the light. This week, think about light. Think about Jesus. And don't go alone. For surely we are journeying with Christ this Lenten season. So friends, let's look for and share, I am the light, all week, all week. Amen.
Quiet our hearts and open our minds to hear the pastoral prayer. O light-giving God, some of us worship you today in a world of darkness, or at best, a world of grayness. Our world has changed so dramatically that it is difficult to remember the way it was even a year ago. Pressures crowd in upon us and are a heavy weight to bear. The causes are varied. The pandemic, bereavement, illness, money, worries about the family, trouble at our work or not having any work at all, boredom, doubt, weariness, and futility. Then there are the bigger issues that may not appear to affect us directly, but you know that they certainly do. Poverty, homelessness, hunger, discrimination based on race, ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, or that we may just not look or act like others. It does not help when we feel that as Christians, we should be doing so much more than we are in addressing these troubles, both personally and within the world in which we live. However, in the midst of our personal and the world's troubles, there is the light of hope, if we dare to seek it. That light resides within and radiates from Jesus the Christ. We find comfort that Jesus came and still comes, not to a perfect world, but to a broken world, our world, to bring light to the darkness, our darkness. We pray for our greater world, a world in need. We pray for our personal world and all those within it, all of whom are in need of your love and your grace, your forgiveness, and a new life of hope, peace, love, and eternal renewal of our faith in you. We pray that you would come alongside us and all those for whom we pray, that you would show us Jesus, the light of the world, the one who came and who still comes to rid us of the darkness, of the grayness, to give us new life and the strength to deal with our troubles, to give us peace, a peace that passes all understanding. We confess that we understand that you wish us to exercise our faith and to respond to your call to allow your light to reside in us and to reflect that light, not only in our personal world and all those within it, but to the communities in which we live and work, to our divided nation, and to the world. Our ability to reflect your light occurs when we live the life, the teachings, and the ministry of Jesus Christ, in whose name and in whose glorious light we now pray. Amen.
Thank you for joining us as we have explored the reality in our lives that Christ is our light. We hope this is helpful to you on your faith journey as we are journeying with Christ this Lenten season as we make our way all the way to Jerusalem. And we're reflecting on and embracing these I am statements of Jesus. I hope you'll continue to join us for worship throughout this Lenten time as we come closer in our walk with Christ, as we deepen our devotion and discipleship with Him. So now, as you go into the week ahead, go with that light, the light that is a lamp to our feet and to our pathway, a light that illumines not only the world around us, but our mind and our hearts, and all that gives us hope and love and faith for the future. So go, knowing that you are totally loved by God, that you are given this wonderful way of seeing by Christ, and that the Spirit always accompanies us on the journey of life itself. So go. Go in joy and love and peace this day. Amen.